Welcome to Limor TV, the place to be to learn about money and get inspired to take small steps to improve your finances. I'm not a financial planner, but I'll show you what I've learned. In today's episode, I'm going to be explaining an emergency fund. Come on, this'll be safe. We've all heard that we should be saving money in an emergency fund, but how many of us actually take that seriously and have calculated how much we actually need? There's two main reasons that you may want to have an emergency fund. The first one is an unexpected increase in your costs, and the second one is an unexpected decrease in your income. Let's explore both. While you may be really good at planning your expenses and budgeting your money, there are certainly instances where unexpected expenses occur for all of us. Perhaps you're in a car accident and you have to pay for some damage, or if you got a new job and the tax wasn't calculated properly. Perhaps when you file your taxes, you find you actually owe the government money. You want to make sure you have money at that point in time to cover the cost so that you don't have to pay a lot of interest when you borrow it. So I recommend that you have at least a few thousand dollars in a savings account for your emergency fund. Unfortunately, in today's society, job losses, being restructured, or being laid off happens quite often. And it also happens to people in their 20s and their 30s, even though we may think of job loss as something that happens more to older people than younger people. The real debate is about how much money you need for how many months and what it's for. So this is where you have to take a good look in the mirror and think about how you manage money. Some experts say that you should have 3 to 8 months worth of money saved up to cover only your necessities, the cost of your rent, the cost of your food, and things that you have to cover. But there's other experts that say you're likely not going to change your lifestyle instantaneously, so you should make sure that you have enough money to cover all of those expenses as well. You should also take into consideration the kind of job that you have and the industry that you work in. If you work in an industry where there's lots of jobs, then it may only take a few months for you to find your next role. But if you have a very specialized role and it takes a long time to find that job because there's not so many out there, you may want to have an emergency fund that has a bit more money in it. That brings me to today's tweetable. Your emergency fund size should be big enough so you can sleep at night. One question that I often hear from people is, what should I be doing with my money that's in my emergency fund? Well, while I can't tell you exactly where to place it, there are some things you're going to want to take into consideration. If you leave your money in cash and you don't have to use your emergency fund for 3, 5, 7 or more years, you'll have lost the opportunity for that money to actually grow. The second thing to take into consideration is having the money locked in or not. So there's times where you can get a better return if you lock in the money for a duration of time, let's say a year or two. But if I were to lock in the money for 2 years and run into an emergency, how would I gain access to it? That's called liquidity. You want to make sure that your money's not locked in so that if you have an emergency, you can access it. The third thing to take into consideration is level of risk. Of course, there's risk and reward. And the more risk we take on, the higher our reward can be. But the whole point of an emergency fund is that you need the money there for you in case you should have an emergency. So you don't want to take on a super risky investment and find that in case of an emergency, you've lost half of your money. That being said, you probably will have a little bit of a hard time finding an investment that has a very strong return and can be converted into cash very quickly and accessible at any point in time. But don't worry, as long as you're making some returns, that's better than nothing. Something else to consider is that when you have a job, you can gain access to credit and access to money. Now, only if you are responsible and if you have access to credit, you don't spend it, you may want to consider having access to that credit so that if you find yourself in a situation where you don't have an income, that credit is still available there to you. That brings me to today's challenge. I want you to take a look at your expenses and think about how much money you would actually need to have in an emergency fund to be able to cover both types of emergencies that I talked about. Did you like this video? Did you learn something? Subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. And if you want even more tips and tricks and inspiration,
come on over to LimorMarkman.money and sign up for email updates.
Remember, I'm not here to change who you are or how you live your life. I just have strategies to make you even more financially fabulous. And you don't have to change what you're doing all that much. Be proud that you're learning and taking small steps to improve your finances. It will give you more confidence and peace of mind. Thanks so much for watching. I'll catch you next time on Limor TV. Bienvenue à Tel Alimor, où vous pouvez apprendre tout sur l'argent et avoir des idées de comment améliorer votre situation. Allons-y! Ça va être super! Let's do it in English.